Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Slaughter Havoc here, and we are back on 10-Minute Tutorials. And as you saw in the description today, we are going to be going over blood runes. Now, in the very first tutorial, we went over altars and orbs, and we talked about the blood runes and how to make them. And that's how we get ourselves all the way out to this Tier 6 altar here. As you can see, we are still a Tier 6 altar, and no, the rain is just not going to happen. We need to go turn that off real quick, because that's just going to annoy me. There we go. So, we can see that we are still a Tier 6 altar. There is absolutely no essence in my altar right now, and our capacity is 10,000. And we're going to go over something really quick, and I'm going to come back to it later on so you understand. So right now our altar is empty. So if I click once, and it's going to fill this altar up to 10,000. But as you can see, it's slowly draining, right? Well, the reason it's slowly draining is there's actually two tanks, technically, in a blood altar. There is the main tank where the capacity says it's 10,000, and then there's a secondary tank, and I can kind of explain them like this. So here's our main tank right here. It has a capacity for 10,000 life points. But there's a secondary tank over here. It is an input and output tank, and it holds 1,000 life essence in it. And towards the end of this episode, I'll come back and explain that because, well, life essence is going to be disappearing. I want to explain where it's going. So right now, see, it's down to 9,000. And it's going to go drop down to 9,000 because 1,000 of it is going to go to the secondary tank over here, and then there'll be 9,000 left in the main tank, right? Okay, hopefully you guys understand that because we're going to come back to that shortly. Actually, it stopped at 902 because I had some blood in it before I did that, but that's okay. So anyways, as you see, it's no longer draining anymore, and if I do a little right click and donate back to the cause, well, our essence is 10,000 and it's going to stay there. So there's 10,000 in the main tank, that guy right there. There's 1,000 in the sub tank, that tank right there. And we'll explain what that is for later. But what we want to concentrate on right now. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Slaughter Havoc here, and we are back on 10-Minute Tutorials. And we are just staring at a blood altar. A blood altar that is currently tier 6. It is filled with 10,000 life essence and a capacity of 1,000. Right? Well, let's get rid of that. Because we actually want to start fresh. So we can kind of show you what some of these things do. It's not a tank, it's an altar I'm looking for. If I can spell today, there we go. So we're gonna go ahead and place our altar down here. We want a fresh altar because there's a couple things we wanna explain really quick. This is our basic altar, and I'm actually gonna get a non-creative sacrificial. Actually, I want the creative too, so we'll come back to that, but I want this guy. So as we went over in the first episode, and we talked about the altars and the orbs, we place our altar down, we did a little right click, we put 200 essence in per click, but if you notice and I right click here, it's going down, 180, 60, and it's going down by 20 every tick. Well, there's a reason for that, and I'm gonna fill this bad boy up a little bit, and we're gonna see that it's gonna continue to keep draining. And there's a reason for that. Technically speaking, in a blood altar, there are two tanks. And I've got them kind of displayed over here so you can kind of understand it. And we'll go over a little bit more later. But the main tank holds 10,000. So when we click on our altar over there and it says our capacity is 10,000, that's actually talking about the main tank, a capacity of 10,000. What it doesn't actually explain to you is there's actually a secondary tank that holds up to 1,000 life essence, or, you know, life points. And this is our input and output tank. And you see it holds 1,000. Now, the reason for this is going to become much more clear later on when we get to some of our other runes down here with the Rune of Acceleration and the Rune of Dislocation. But we're not there yet. We're with our Rune of Sacrifice, the first one we're going to go over. So the Rune of Sacrifice, pretty simple. It's 4 stone, 2 glowstone, 2 reinforced slates, which are our tier 2 slates, and our blood orb. And we are going to get Runes of Sacrifice. Now, the reason that these are beneficial, and I'm making sure this is done, so it's at 1800. If I do a donation and then check again, you'll see it's at 2,000 because that's how much we get per click, right? Well, not if we swap these out. So I put this Rune of Sacrifice in and we're still at just 2,000, right? But now if I donate to the cause and check on it again, you're going to see it's actually 2220. It added an additional 20 per self-sacrifice in rune. So if we're 2220 and I add in 1, 2, 3, we'll add 4 more in. That'll give us an even 100. All right, so we're gonna add 4 more of these in. So we're at 2,200. We now have 20, 40, 60, 80, 100 extra. So instead of 200, when I donate now, we're gonna go from 2,220. We should get 300 now because we have an additional 20 per. As you can see, now we got 300. We're at 2320. Or sorry, 2520. So as you can see, each one of these runes adds an additional 20 life essence per sacrifice. Pretty sweet if you're trying to set up a self-sacrificing setup to get as much blood into the altar as possible. You just put down a whole bunch of these. Now we have 8 of them, which is going to be an extra, what? Well, 4 of them is 80, so 160. So now every donation is going to be 360. So if I donate and do this, you'll see that we went from 2520 to 2380, which is an additional 360. So that's an extra 160 from what our original donation was. I hope that makes sense because we're moving on. The next one we're going to do is actually going to be, let me swap this out with a regular rune real quick, because I don't want to have these guys here while we're working on the next one. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go over the sacrifice rune. Now, we didn't really explain this before, but as you can see, our current essence is at 2880. Now, if I grab myself Mr. Cow here, and if I place him up on the altar, oh, you know what? Let me make this guy first. This is our dagger of sacrifice. So I'm going to put him here, and I'm going to put my cow here. Okay, so the dagger of sacrifice is made by putting an iron sword in your tier 2 altar with at least 3,000 life essence, and you get this dagger of sacrifice. And what this guy does is it allows us to use mobs to donate to the cause. So as you see, we've got 2880 in the altar right now. And if I throw my Mr. Bessie cow here and sacrifice Mr. Bessie here, and then I check, you can see we jumped up to 3130. So sacrificing a mob gave us 250. Now that's pretty cool. So it's actually more than we get for donating from ourselves. We're donating from a mob and we get 250 for it. But now if we add one of these sacrificing runes here, and I throw Bessie back up on the altar and do a little sacrifice, we're actually going to get more than just that 250. We're actually going to get 275. We're going to get an additional 25 per. So instead of 250, we're now getting 275. So if I wanted to add, you know, 4 of these guys in here like this, instead of getting 250, since we have 4 at 25 each, we're actually going to get 350. So if I throw Bessie up on the altar, or close to the altar, and sacrifice Bessie to the blood gods, you'll see that we actually jumped up to 350. So it's 250 plus the additional 100 from these 4 sacrificing runes. This right here is how you're going to start automating your system or finding a more practical way to fill your life essence. You can build a farm up above it and just start sacrificing away and fill this guy up pretty darn quickly. But now there's also different rates you can get. A friendly mob is going to give us 250. But right now, what were we at? We're currently at 3755. If I throw a spider up here and sacrifice, you're going to see that I actually get quite a bit more. I got, 250 minus 5. So 245 plus another 455. So that's 700 essence. So I get 600 for the mob, plus an additional 25 for each one of these runes of sacrifice, which gives me 700 for a hostile mob. That is a pretty quick way to get this thing filled up. 700 per, so I just sacrificed 2. So in 2 swings, I just increased myself 1,400. That is awesome. But not quite as awesome as this guy right here. Now, I do feel kind of bad about this. The Tacificates are, well, they're just friendly little guys that like to trade with us. But you know what? They're also very valuable guys. And if you can see, I sacrifice him to the altar. And I check my altar again. I actually jumped up 2,800. That is huge. 2,800. Now, granted, we've increased using these guys right here. So the rate is a little bit different. And I don't believe it's actually, it might be a 10% increase. It may not actually be, that's what it is. It's 10%. Sorry, it's not like 20 and 25. We originally get 200. And when we do our regular sacrifice and we get an increase of 10%, which takes us to 220. For a regular mob, we get 250, but we increase 10%, which is 25 more, which takes us to 275. So each one adds that much. So if I throw Mr. Testificate back on here, wait, where'd you go? Well, let me grab that egg again real quick. Throw you on here and donate like that. and check our life essence. Now you'll see, I believe it's just 2,000. Yeah, it's 2,000 for a villager. But since we added 2,000, which is 200, we're going to get an additional 800 for those four runes that we had in there. So, yes, that is the Rune of Sacrifice. Pretty freaking cool. So if you have a way like Mine Factory Reloaded, we have auto-spawners. You can just auto-spawn villagers. You can get a life, lot of life essence really, really quickly. Pretty freaking snazzy. Now, we're going to move on to the Rune of Speed, because the Rune of Speed is freaking sweet. We have made our runes, right? We are our blank slates. We know how long this process can take. We put a piece of stone in there, and we wait a pretty long time. We sing songs, we do whatever. And it took a really long time to get these slates that we actually needed to make these runes, right? That took quite a while. But now we can add in our Rune of Speed. So I'm going to knock a couple of these out real quick and kind of show you. I don't actually know what the rate conversion is for speed, but I do know it's pretty darn dramatic. Check this out. I'm going to put you there. I'm going to grab some stone here and watch how fast this is. And done. So much faster. If I put another row of these speed runes in here, oh, get back here, and do this, it'd just be that much faster. And done. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. So the speed runes, quite helpful. The recipe for these guys are pretty simple. Oops, we're here. It's just two sugar with, wait, that's not my speed rune. Yeah, it is. Two sugar with a blood rune, four stone, two blank slates. Gives us speed runes. Pretty freaking sweet. Pretty easy. That's our speed runes. Next, we're going to go into superior capacity. So we know we're limited on our capacity of 10,000, right? Our big tank right there, 10,000. I'm going to put it back today. But if we add these guys in, we're going to add in one at a time just to kind of show you. So I should probably, no, I don't want superior. I want augmented. Augmented capacity. And these guys are pretty easy to make. Not too expensive. Oop, wrong one. Augmented capacity. It's three empty buckets with a couple stones and a tier 3 slate, the Imbune slate. And if we add one of these guys in, and let me grab my regular rune. Come on. There we go. We're going to do this. And so we've just added one augmented capacity. But if I come over here and click on the altar, you'll see my capacity is now 12,000. It adds 2,000 per block. So come back over here again, give it a second update, and it's now 14,000. So if I put a couple of these guys in, like five of them, like I'm doing right here, that's 2 times 5, which is 10,000, which will actually bump our altar up to 20,000. Pretty sweet. We can increase our altar pretty quick. But eventually, once we hit 15 of these, and we get ourselves up to a 40,000 altar, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to put these guys back in. We're kind of working against ourselves because we've got this guy in our arsenal, the Rune of Superior Capacity. And what the Rune of Superior Capacity does, well, first of all, I'll show you. It takes an augmented capacity with a tier 4 slate, which is a demonic slate, a couple obsidian, and two buckets. Now, by this time, guys, yeah, it's getting kind of expensive, but you probably got it to do it. This one is a little bit different. Now, if you see I add this guy, it's not going to be 2,000. It's actually only going to be 1,000. I'm at 1,100. So it's not as good as its predecessor because this one gives me a 10% increase where the other one gives me a flat 2,000 increase. But if I get 15 of these guys in, so I'm actually going to put 14 in to start. So there's 5. There's 10. There's 14. Now, if we added 14 of our augmented capacity, that would give us an additional 28,000, which would put us at 38,000. And if you look right here, we're only at 37,974. So we're 26 short. We're not quite there. But if I were to add augmented capacity or a 15th automatic capacity, it would put us to 40,000, right? Well, if I add a 15th superior capacity, we now surpass that and we're up to 4,177. So if I add a whole nother row of these over here, you'll see that this starts going up drastically fast. If I put these bad boys in here, now this would be 7 more, so it'd be another 14,000, which would put me at 57,000 if it was augmented capacity. But with the superior capacity, I am now at 81,402. So what the superior capacity does is it does an increase of 10% every time, whereas the augmented capacity just does an additional 2,000 every time. So once you hit 15 of these, it's easier to just switch over to the runes of superior capacity and call it a day. Now, for the last two, and this is going to take us back to what I was discussing earlier about these tanks. So I'm going to grab these guys right here. And is that my creative one? Yes. And I'm going to go ahead and fill this bad boy up. So now this tank is totally maxed out at 81,362 just from some runes. And look how many more runes we can still put on, guys. There's tons of combinations you can do however you want to do it. We've got a ton of speed runes. We've got a whole bunch of our superior capacity runes. You got all these extra runes you can still adjust your altar with. So there's all types of options. But this is going to take us back to that 1,000 thing I was talking about. So what I'm going to do is I'm using thermal expansion, thermal dynamics, and I'm going to go ahead and throw a little tank on here. Now, nothing's happening right now because I got to throw a servo on here. But if you watch and I set this to off, this is going to start filling up. And you see it just filling up, right? And it's going to fill up relatively, well, I wouldn't say quickly. As you can see, it's doing 20 life essence per. Now, it took the first 1,000 that was in that tank, right? And it's now doing 20 per tick. That's kind of slow. Let's speed the process up with runes of acceleration. Now I'm going to go ahead and state right here, I don't know what the rate of acceleration is. I don't know what the differential rate is, but it accelerates it drastically. Oh, I'm sorry. This is actually the rate of acceleration. I'm talking about the rate of disassociation, because as we check, they're still going to be going out at 20 per, right? 20 ticks per, 20 per tick, much, much quicker. You can see the process is faster, but it's still pretty, pretty slow. Now, if we add in these runes of dislocation, watch the increased rate of transfer. Boop. Now we'll go over here, and this tank should be filling up pretty darn quickly. Look at that. Look how fast it is transferring over. That tank is just filling right up. Okay, so if I take these guys off, because I did these out of order, and I do apologize. Let me go ahead and grab you. All right, and I'm going to swap you out. There we go. Fill this bad boy back up. So the runes of dislocation helps you pipe out of your altar as fast as possible into one of these portable tanks. Now, it's already done because this tank has reached its capacity, but the other tank is filling up. That tank, the little guy over there, is filling back up because this tank is already full, right? So this is going to eventually get down to, I don't know, whatever rate it gets to. It'll get there eventually. But it's also increasing the outbound tank, and that's the runes of dislocation. It makes that tank bigger, but now it's stopped. And so you see it's 6532. Now, if I reverse this flow, so I'm going to take this guy off right here, and I'm going to put him here and turn it off, and then reverse the flow on this tank, you'll see it starts dumping into this tank pretty darn quickly. And wow, all of it's just going right back in. So it filled that other tank, right? And now that tank, and like I said, I don't know the rates. I do apologize, but it increases that little tank over there. These guys, the runes of dislocation, increase the rate of that tank. And I believe it's 10% per rune. So it's quite a few that we did right there. And now they're going back into the tank because all that blood is more than that tank could hold. And it's going to refill this one. But if we go ahead and switch this back, and I'm going to try to make this fast as possible because this is the last thing we're going to go over. If I put you here and take you all back out of the tank, right? Yep, there we go. And start filling this bad boy back up. And I put in some of these runes of acceleration. That's going to speed up the transfer rate. So I'm going to take these out. So the tier, well, whatever, is changing. It's going down at a 20 tick rate again, right? But now I'm going to put these runes of acceleration in and watch how much faster it transfers over. Now it is going quite fast. Look how fast that is. So that increases the rate at which it transfers. These over here, and I'm sorry I missed it at first, these over here increase the tank size from 1,000 to, I believe it's 10% per block. And then these ones over here increase the rate of change between this tank and your blood altar. And it happens pretty quickly. So guys, I hope that was clear enough. I know I made a little bit of mistake when I first said it at the very end, but just remember, dislocation increases that little tank over there. The rune of acceleration increases the rate of change between a tank and your altar. So you can store up a whole bunch of blood altar or blood over here and then input it into your tank later on, however you want to do it. Anyways, guys, that is runes for the altar. I hope you enjoyed. Hope this was helpful. If not, I do apologize. If it was, great. Subscriptions and likes are always appreciated, but not necessary. I am Slaughter Havoc, and I'm out of here. Peace.